بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
الحمد لله الحمد لله الحمد لله. We've reached Eid and we have finished Ramadan, and we know that it's a little hot today, and we know that our nafs needs to sit through this hotness for a few seconds, inshallah, for a few minutes. And it's appropriate, this hotness might be appropriate at the end of Ramadan, because Ramadan comes from a word which means to scorch, which means to burn. And Allah burns off your sins during this month that we just finished, alhamdulillah. And this month that we just finished is like as what one of our teachers described it as, a madrasa, where you learned to be with the Quran, to be with Allah, to have taqwa of Allah, to have consciousness of Allah. This is the month that we just finished, alhamdulillah, the month of consciousness of Allah. And Allah says about this month in the Quran, yuridullahu bikum al-yusra wa la yuridu bikum al-usr. That He wants from you what? He wants yusuf. He wants ease for us in this month. And we're thinking ease for us in this month. When we can't eat from before sunrise until sunset, how is that ease? Wa la yuridu bikum al-usr. He doesn't want difficulty for us. How is that ease? But what ease we recognize and realize from this month is the ease of how easy it is. How easy it is to abstain from even the halal. Even from the halal, that we have to stay away from food. We have to stay away from any sort of pleasures during this month, many different types of pleasures during this month. The halal pleasures in this month. So Allah shows us how easy it is to avoid those pleasures. Then what about the pleasure, what about the haram when the rest of the month passes? When this month passes and the next month comes, when Shawwal comes, what about the haram? How easy it is to avoid that? How easy is it to avoid that? That Allah is teaching us through this month, the ease of avoiding the haram, and the ease of holding our nafs back, holding our ego back, holding our wings back, holding our hawa back from our desires. This is what Allah teaches us in this month. That the Sahib al-Burda, Imam al-Busiri, says about the nafs, وَالنَّفْسُ كَالطِّفْلِ إِنْ تَحْمِلْهُ شَبَّعَ عَلَىٰ حُبِّ الرِّضَاعِ وَإِنْ تَفْتِنْهُ يَنْفَطِنِ. That the nafs, that the ego is like a child. The ego is like a child. And if you let it suckle on the milk past its due date, then it'll grow to love that before past its time, but after it's appropriate. But if you wean it off, it'll wean off. You can train your nafs. You can train your nafs to have taqwa of Allah. You can train your nafs to submit to Allah, to be a Muslim, to submit to Allah. Not to submit to your nafs, not to make the religion of Allah submit to yourself, to submit to Allah. You can, and Allah shows us in this month that by standing the nights in prayer and by spending the days in a little bit of hunger, with a little bit of thirst, that this is what Allah teaches us during this month. And then when this month is over, then what does Allah say? وَلِتُكَبِّرُ اللَّهَ عَلَىٰ مَا هَدَاكُمْ وَلَعَلَّكُمْ تَشْكُرُونَ. So that you may glorify Allah, exalt Allah. And what do we say when the Eid comes? What are we doing right before the Eid prayer? Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. La ilaha illallah, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, wa lillahi alhamd. That Allah is the greatest, Allah is the greatest, Allah is the greatest. And there is no deity other than Allah. And to Him is all praise. تُكَبِّرُ Allah. So that we may glorify Allah. وَلَعَلَّكُمْ تَشْكُرُونَ. And so you might have thankfulness for this opportunity that has come to us. The opportunity for us to see what we're capable of. The opportunity to hold our nafs back. The opportunity to worship Allah. The opportunity to worship Allah with the people around us. To have our hearts together in the Taraweeh prayers that we pray. And then have our hearts together at the iftars and at the shuhur. And to have our hearts together at the Eid prayer. This is what Allah wants to teach us. Allah wants to teach us gratefulness. Allah wants to teach us taqwa. This is what is expected of us. And Allah wants us to build these good habits. That if you have built a good habit, it takes about 40 days to build a good habit. Alhamdulillah, we just had 30 days on Ramadan. So you only have 10 more days to go. Whatever good habits that you built in this month, keep going for 10 more days. That there are 6 fasts of Shawwal that come after Ramadan. The Prophet said, whoever fasts those 6 months of Shawwal, it's as if he has fasted the entire year. So fast 6 more days, inshallah. You don't have to do it all during Shawwal. Just do it before the next Ramadan. Fast the 6 more days. Build these habits. continue to read Quran, continue to if you pray 20 rakat in Taraweeh, try praying 2 extra nafl after Isha. Keep these good habits going, and don't allow yourself to fall back into post Ramadan laxity. The Sharia still applies. You know, a lot of times in Eid, we think the Sharia doesn't apply. There's perhaps people who didn't pray Fajr today. Perhaps there's people who are going to miss some prayers today because of the festivities. That this is still the deen of Allah. That we still submit to Allah, and Allah does not submit to us. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم لسائر المسلمين يا قوم استغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. After the ayat, بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. After the ayat of Ramadan, Allah says, وَإِذَا سَأَلَكَ عِبَادِي عَنِّي فَإِنِّي قَرِيبٌ. That if my servant asks of me, فَإِنِّي قَرِيبٌ, then indeed I am close. And we should have learned to ask from Allah in this month. We should have learned to ask from Allah in this month, to make dua to Allah, to have tawakkul in Allah. That if you see something that bothers you, when you walk outside, alhamdulillah, I was speaking to one of my friends, an elder that I consider a mentor. And he said, when you look outside and you see the pollution, before you say, I wish someone could do something about this pollution, say, I pray that Allah does something about this pollution through someone. Let's recognize that Allah is the one that is the fa'al, the active agent, and we're just the means. To have trust in Allah. We should have learned trust in this month. And then when this month is over, that we continue our taqwa, we continue our shukr, we continue to exalt Allah, and we continue to rely on Allah, and to continue to ask from Allah. That the Ramadan is not the only time in the year that we ask. We ask in every moment of our lives. We ask in every moment of our lives. And this month of Ramadan is taught us taqwa, God consciousness, so that we see Allah in every step that we take. That before we take a step, we ask, what is Allah's ruling on this thing? This is what we should have learned in this month. Before we do anything, we have Allah in our hearts first. La ilaha illahu, that there's nothing in our hearts except Allah. And whatever is in your heart is your ilah. Whatever you keep in your heart is your ilah. So if your nafs, or if your hawa, or if your wealth, or your status, or your fame, or whatever it may be is in your heart, then you have taken that as your ilah. And we ask Allah for refuge from taking anything other than Him as our ilah. And we ask Allah that He makes us the people who have taqwa. We ask Allah that He makes us the people who have shukr. We ask Allah that we are able to finish this day. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. La ilaha illallah, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, wa lillahi alhamd. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. La ilaha illallah, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, wa lillahi alhamd. We ask Allah that there's nothing in our hearts except Him. We ask Allah that there's no source of peace for us other than Him. And for that we say, Allahumma anta as-salam, wa minka as-salam, tabarakta ya dhal jalali wal ikram, hayyina wa adkhilna dar as-salam, rabbana atina fid dunya hasana, wa fil akhirati hasana, wa qina adhab an-nar, rabbana hab lana min أزواجنا وذرياتنا قرة أعين وجعلنا للمتقين إماما. We ask Allah that we have appreciation for our teachers, and our first teachers, our parents. We ask Allah for their mercy. So we say, رب ارحمهما كما ربياني صغيرا. 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 We ask Allah that we recognize that Allah and His angels send their salutations and their blessings on the Prophet ﷺ, and we ask Him the same. إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على زين الوجود سيدنا ومولانا وحبيبنا وقرة عيننا وشفيعنا واعتمادنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد وعلى أصحاب سيدنا محمد وعلى أزواج سيدنا محمد ولا أصحاب سيدنا محمد ولا أنصار سيدنا محمد وعلى أتباع سيدنا محمد وعلى أحباب سيدنا محمد وعلى أمة سيدنا محمد وبارك وسلم وصلي عليه. إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر. لا إله إلا الله والله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد. عيدكم مبارك. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله.